Hey guys, it's Blaine from Earhart Racing. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Tacon Cavalry. I know it's been a little while since I last reviewed this vehicle, and I did want to get a final review of the current state of the vehicle. It was a brand new car when I bought it. In terms of on the market and everything, I was probably one of the first to buy this vehicle in the States. And I was really excited to get my hands on it because it's a beautiful car, especially when it's all, you know, shiny and new and has a front plate and stuff like that. But some of the problems with this vehicle have been the roll cage is pretty expensive at $40 and the body is $35. Well, that's not super expensive for a body. It is a little bit expensive for a body that I was breaking a lot. As an inexperienced driver, I think I did my last review of this vehicle about 6 months ago. And now I feel like I've come a long way with my ability to control the vehicles and keep them in one part around the track. I know that sounds hilarious, but I have come a long way. I've gotten a lot more into the hobby and I enjoy it a lot. But I don't think this is a vehicle for inexperienced drivers without a lot of money because it has those parts that do break. And I'll show you which parts break and where. This is part of the roll cage, and it's broken, and I have four of these actually broken all in the same place, and they just don't like surviving. They have a real weak spot, which is a huge bummer. It's right there, and it just snaps when you land on your rear end, which happens. I mean, life happens. So you just come in, you know, and it just not a good landing, and you smash it, you know, and boom, you've got broken parts. And that'll happen with any car, but the only reason I'm recommending a different car, like the Tacon Soar, for instance, is for the price, because it's $40 every time you break that piece. Another piece that breaks is this piece up here. It's the bumper support piece. It's right here. I actually have one back here to show you. And so basically, it's this little guy right here, and you can see it's just sheared off right there. It's pretty thin. It doesn't have crazy support, and that's when you land on your front. I mean, and this vehicle handles really well, but for an inexperienced driver who doesn't know what they're doing, they might land it on their back or their front every once in a while. So it's a great car, though. We'll get into that. Other little things that I've done to this vehicle are the screws. The head started to kind of like, on these bottom ones, I think I had two of them break on me, which was pretty shocking. I did not like that, not one bit. So I replaced them with a better screw. I think it was like from RCScrewz or something like that. I'll put a link in the description of that kit. The kit was not complete, however. The whole vehicle, it didn't have like some of these more important screws up here because they're really long. And that was a big bummer. I had to go to the hobby shop and buy those, but that not a huge deal, I suppose. I really like the stock electronics. The only thing that I've really replaced was the servo once, and you know, I think it was deserved. I've driven this car a lot, and $12 for a new servo sounds great. I haven't had the motor or the ESC problems or anything like that. Every once in a while, I'll switch to my Spectrum receiver into this vehicle. It just depends on the day and if I'm like racing or whatever on the track. So I don't usually race with this vehicle. While it is really nice and really well handling, I kind of feel like it's cheating, to be honest. It handles really well. It stays on the track. The jumps so well. And it turns and handles in the dirt really, really nice. Like, just a great car. I mean, it doesn't have a crazy amount of clearance, but on a track with just a bit of dirt on it, it will do amazing. Especially compared to just a buggy vehicle that's a lot lighter than this vehicle. It handles, I think, a little bit better and cleaner than the buggy. And it's a lot of fun to drive. It jumps, and as long as you keep the gas on, this thing is just pretty much a straight jumper. The parts are really, really good quality. A lot of aluminum on this vehicle. This is the brushless version. And I haven't had a whole lot of problems with parts in general, just those couple of parts, and then the rest were acceptable, you know, not out of the norm, I'd say. Other things that are really good to know about this vehicle is I don't mind this remote. It's what's in the vehicle most of the time when I drive this vehicle. It requires 4 AA's, which is great, not 8 or anything crazy. It's got your trims and stuff that you need, and I feel like it does the job for a simple little $10 remote. It's great. It's a lot better, honestly, than some of the remotes I've gotten a lot with some of the low C vehicles and stuff that I've purchased, in terms of how it feels. I can't comment on range. I've never had an issue with that, really. Other than that, these are sold on Nitro RCX, and they're also sold on AtomikRC. And recently, I got really lucky and spotted some deals on Cyber Monday. And so I got a lot of crazy amount of parts. Like, I went a little bit crazy because the deals were that good. For instance, I've got 3 of these now, and they were $8 a piece. This is the roll cage right here, just so everybody can see. And if you notice, this is LC Racing, and LC Racing is sold by AtomikRC, whereas the Tacon brand is sold by Nitro RCX. And then, like, I got some of these, and these were all Amazon Prime, which was amazing, because a lot of times Nitro RCX will charge $10 for shipping, and sure, they come within the week or whatever, but Prime, I swear, that stuff is business, and it's real cheap in comparison, and getting your parts real fast. We drive these vehicles with 2S LiPos. These work really well. I've never tried them with 3S LiPo. That's probably why I don't have electronic issues. This is my favorite one out of all of them, the 2200 milliamp hour Traxxas 25C 7.4 volt LiPo, 2-cell, great little thing. My second favorite one, just because it fits really well in both the Soar and the buggy, and it's extremely cheap, is the Turnigy 1700 milliamp hour. I mean, these things last 30 to 45 minutes. So, and the last one, this one doesn't fit the best. It's a little bit small, but 2000 milliamp hours, 20C, and it fits and it drives just as well. I've soldered Deans onto all my cars just for the ease of it. I have quite a few cars these days, so I think that's about it for this vehicle. Just a few take-home notes is it's excellent for more experienced drivers, because I feel like they won't wreck it and just have that buyer's remorse having to buy $40 worth of parts just to get this one part that they need. It could be good for a beginner if they can get the kit that they talked about. I asked the distributor, I asked the creator of the vehicle if they were going to do anything. I believe they're in China or something like that, or Japan sounds most right. And they said they were going to release a better kit, but they still haven't, which is such a bummer for a car like this, because that one part right there, I guess two, they really break, and that's a huge bummer. One other thing to note on the vehicle is that you can use other bumpers. If you're just breaking the bumpers, I've used, I believe this is the MT bumper, and I just broke it. And I replaced it with the stock one because I got a bunch of nice, awesome, super cheap roll cages. But yeah, anyways, so try a couple different bumpers if you want. This is the one I have, MT, yay. It worked. It wasn't the best. It didn't protect this little area the best. I made a custom one because I didn't want to pay $35 for these little things. But now I got mine for $8, so I would definitely recommend checking out Amazon. This has been Blaine from Earhart Racing RC. I love this car. Take a look at it, and I'll put some links in the description. Thanks. Bye.